Hi everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about the Polygon tool, the Star tool, and the Flare tool. And you can find these right under the Rectangle tool. After you click and hold, you'll see some tools, and we're going to be talking about these three right down here. So let's start off with the Polygon tool. So I just opened a new document with Command N, or you can also go to File New, and then just hit return. Then you can just place your mouse and drag like this. And as you're dragging, one cool thing about the Polygon tool is you can use your up and down arrows. So you can't let off while you're dragging, but you can use your up and down arrows on the keyboard to adjust how many sides that polygon is gonna get. Well, once you decide how many you want, you can just let off, and now you have your polygon. If you have your control pulled up, if you don't, go to Window and go to Control here. And it'll give you a kind of a bar of information and things you can change about whatever you're working on. So as you can see, this polygon is selected. If it's not, you can just highlight it with your V or selection tool. And then you can come over here to shape and click that. And here's where you can adjust how many sides manually. If you know exactly how many sides you want, you can change that here. You can change rotation. You can change corners to round them. So this changes the radius of your shape, and this changes how long one side of your shape is. So there are different ways to increase or decrease the size of your shape. On one of the sides, there will be this little square, and if you click right on that and drag, you can adjust the sides that way too. So that's just another option. So that is Polygon. Pretty simple, really. Okay, let's move on to the Star tool. So click and hold and get that tool up, and this Star tool, you can click and drag and do the same thing. You can use your up and down arrows to adjust the number of points. Another cool thing about the Star tool is, as you're drawing, you can hold Option to get a different type of star. We'll draw one more so I can show you something else. As you're drawing, you can also hold and release Command or Control on a PC to get really long ends of your star. Once you find the ones that you like, you can let off the Command or Control key. And if you decide that you don't like the long ones, you can just hold Option and it will bounce back to your regular star. Now, if you are in Illustrator CC, you can adjust the star points one way. You can hit A and then click on one endpoint. And you see this little circle right here. You can just drag that down. You can do this with any sharp point of any path in Illustrator if you have anything newer than CS6, so any version of CC. But you can do all of them at the same time by hitting A, which is your direct selection tool, and then getting on that little circle and pulling them all in. So it's a pretty quick way to round your corners. All right, now let's talk a little bit about the flare. Flare is something that, you know, I really honestly do not use that often, but it can be pretty cool if you know some cool ways to use it. So I'm going to just draw a box. I did that with my rectangle tool. And I am going to come over here and get a dark blue fill color. And just make sure that this one is on top, not the stroke. Otherwise, you'll have a blue stroke instead. Now we'll grab the flare tool. And I'm just going to click once. And that will bring up my flare tool options. The flare tool looks different depending on what background that you put it on, just like a lens flare in Photoshop would. There are a lot of little things you can adjust in here. You can adjust your diameter, you can up your opacity here of your center stuff. This is all for the center. Brightness can be decreased or increased. And then the number of rays, you can change all that here. How much halo there is. I'm going to put that up a little bit. There we go. And then your rings, how big they are, how many there are, that kind of thing. So all of your things to change. I just kind of mess with these until it's the look that I want. Well, I'm going to hit Command H and that will hide my edges so we can just look at the lens flare itself. Okay, and now for the fun part. If you go up here to Effect and go to Distort and Transform, we'll go to Transform, and then I'm going to just put Move up a little bit, and we'll preview that. And then we're going to make 20 copies. And so you can get some really cool little effects just from playing with these Transform tools. And this is still editable later, so that's really cool. Say OK. And then here in your appearance, you can see your flare, contents, and transform. You just click on transform and you have the ability to adjust those again. Just make sure your preview button is pushed to see all of the little cool things that you can make with the flare tool. So play around with that. It could lead to something really awesome in your designs. And now I'm going to show you a couple of designs that I made with this, just so you can kind of get some ideas. This one has a twist on it and it has transform. So transform, I reflected X and Y, and that's why you're getting kind of a mirror image here. And I have 20 copies. With this other one, this one has 10 copies and it's moved a little bit over. So you can kind of see just the crazy amount of possibilities there are when you start playing with the flare tool. It can add some unique stuff to your designs. So give that a try and let me know how it goes. And if you enjoyed this video, please click on the like button. And I will see everyone next Thursday for my next video. Thank you.